buy nine, only $169.99. It's Spring Sanity, only at Source for Sports on Pembina.
None of a
Hey, neighbor. Trouble getting the lawnmower going?
Think the gas has gone bad?
You ever try Aspen Fuel?
Aspen Fuel?
Yeah, it lasts up to 5 years, and it's better for your machine and the environment. I first tried it in my ice auger. Now I use it in my lawn trimmer, chainsaw, and snowblower. Now I don't worry about fuel going bad, and Aspen Fuel contains less harmful substances, so it burns cleaner with less harmful exhaust fumes.
For an Aspen dealer near you, contact Yetman's Limited in Winnipeg.
This is SportsCenter.
I'm Joe Marcoux with this TSN 1290 SportsCenter update. Well, all reports are indicating that John Tortorella will become the next head coach of the Vancouver Canucks, but GM Mike Gillis is not tipping his hand.
I can't say at this point, but John is certainly in the mix and been very strong, and so we're going to finish off the process the way we designed it initially, and that should take us... it shouldn't take us much longer.
Mike Gillis on the team 1040 this afternoon. Elsewhere, Alain Vigneault, who has shown the door in Vancouver, landed with the Rangers. The Stars inked Lindy Ruff. And Coyotes coach Dave Tippett has been extended for another 5 years. It's Santa Lucia Pizza Goldeyes game day as the Fish play two tonight against the visiting Lincoln Saltdogs. Coverage gets going at 6. And in the majors, the Jays 12-4 in the month of June open up a three-gamer with the Orioles. R.A. Dickey 6-8 facing Jason Hamill.
This Sports Center update is brought to you by
High Visity. If you have a job where your safety and performance depends on your ability to be seen, then you need highly visible clothing from High Visity. 891 Century or highvisity.com.
TSN 1290, Winnipeg's sports leader with Sports Center updates 24 hours a day and breaking sports news anytime at tsn1290.ca. Now back to Hustler and Lawless. Drive to the game on TSN 1290.
Brought to you in part by Landau Ford Lincoln. Landau, what a dealership should be.
Well, thou shalt not speak about the 52-0 beatdown last night in Guelph. It was a preseason game. Put that in the rearview mirror. Looking ahead to next Thursday, though, big challenge for the city, transit, and the Blue Bombers to get things right for Blue Bomber fans going to the big game to open up the new stadium officially. Gary, we heard the new plan. It sounds like a lot of work has been done to alleviate some of the problems, but there's a bill for that, isn't there?
Yeah, well, the Bombers, you know, they, if you have a ticket to the game, they give you a free ride on the bus, but that doesn't come for free. Someone has to pay for that. And the Bombers, they pay the city for that. And, you know, they originally...
Adding cops now as well?
And now, yeah, and they originally kind of, you know, estimated, you know, they were going to have 5,000 people who were going to use transit per game. Well, now they're talking about 10 to 12,000 people are going to use public transit for games. So that doubles that budget. And then with the extra cop budget, I'm told the number could be as much as an extra $1 million per season when all is said and done. And that's a pretty significant number for the Bombers. You know, they were hoping to turn a certain profit that would allow them to pay down their debt, put money aside. You take $1 million out of that pie right off the bat. Huge money. It'd be interesting to see how that Jim Bell wouldn't address that number in the press conference today. But we'll know the number at the end of the year because, you know, all this is public information.
Regardless, they need to get it right for the fans this week, or they're going to have a white elephant. I've got confidence that they will. We'll find out what it costs after the fact. Big thanks to all of our guests. Michael Remus popping in on the warm-up. Steve Drager, Troy Westwood, Pierre LeBrun, Sarah McClellan, Mike Mazzeo, Cam Cole, Kristen Odlin, Mike Heike, and Joe Haggerty. Wow, what a show. Stay tuned, folks. The Fish have a double dip, and it's up next on TSN 1290. Have a great weekend. Thanks for listening. We'll see you Monday, 3 p.m. with a warm-up here on the home of sports in Peg City, TSN 1290. We're out.
Oh, my God. Oh! Shut it down.
There they go!
You've been listening to Hustler and Lawless.
That was brilliant.
Tune in every weekday from 4 to 6 to get your fix of H&L on TSN 1290.
TSN 1290 traffic.
For Rogers, buckle up, Winnipeg. Canada's fastest and largest LTE Max network has arrived. Only from Rogers.
Making our way into that evening drive, and we're now getting word of a crash eastbound Portage Avenue at Westwood in your far left-hand lanes. You might see some tie-ups through there. A couple vehicles involved in that one. This is all in addition to our earlier incident southbound on Henderson Highway where we had that pedestrian involved in a crash. Now, southbound Henderson still closed at Edison. Westbound Edison is also closed, and we do still have police on the scene. They're redirecting traffic. Now, around the rest of the city, some of those lineups should be starting to taper off a little bit. Might see a little bit of extra traffic westbound Logan at Salter where we are dealing with a stalled vehicle and some new construction westbound Bishop Brandon. You lose your curb lane right around Shore Hill. First time ever and for 10 days only, get 0% financing for 84 months on the entire 2013 Chevrolet lineup, only until Saturday, June 22nd. I'm Sabrina Carnevale.
Final look at the CTV News Skywatch weather for tonight. Chance of showers, low of 16. For Saturday, chance of showers, high of 23. And for Sunday, showers, high of 21. Right now in Winnipeg, under some clouds, it's 21.
Weather brought to you by
Exclusive Carpets, 441 St. Mary's Road. Their warehouse is so big, it was almost considered for Winnipeg's new stadium. But for now, it's still packed with a massive selection of flooring at amazing low prices.
Winnipeg Recycling and Garbage Services. Reduce, reuse, recycle, repeat. For you, for our city.
Be picky about your plastics. Winnipeg's recycling program can't accept plastic bags, so please don't put them in your blue recycling cart. Reuse your plastic bags or return them to the store for recycling. You can recycle all your plastic bottles and plastic packaging with Recycling Triangle. But remember, don't put your recycling in a bag, and no plastic bags of any sort in your recycling cart. For more information, phone 311 or visit winnipeg.ca.
Hi, I'm Denny from Denny's Whole Hog Barbecue, proud to be made in Manitoba.
And I'm quarterback Buck Pierce, and I want you to call Denny's Whole Hog Barbecue now to book your fully catered barbecue or try a do-it-yourself hog roast.
It's fun, delicious, will cost less than you think. Plus, you can keep the leftovers, we'll even pack it up for you.
Visit dannyswholehog.com or call 344-5675.
And we'll bring the flavor.
By Manitoba.
Taste. Smile. Repeat.
There are so many great places to tee off in Manitoba, so grab your clubs and get ready to play all summer long.
Discover the wild beauty and majestic views of Hecla Golf Course, just 2 hours north of Winnipeg. Visit lakelandgolfmanagement.com. Toulon Golf and Country Club is an 18-hole championship course known for its lush and gorgeous fairways. Visit ToulonGC.com. The best golf trip you'll ever take. Pinawa Golf Club, just 100 kilometers northeast of Winnipeg. The course that nature built. Visit PinawaClub.mb.ca.
Discover Southwood Golf and Country Club, nestled beside the quiet tranquility of the St. Norbert Monastery in LaSalle River. Visit Southwood.ca today.
Join one of Winnipeg's most successful private golf clubs, Breezy Bend Country Club, 3 minutes west of the perimeter on Roblin Boulevard. Visit breezybend.ca or call 889-GOLF.
From tee to green, there's plenty of courses to play around this summer in Manitoba.
TSN 1290, CFRW Winnipeg. All sports.
This is my spot.
All the time. A division of Bell Media.
Play ball! 2-2. It's on the outside edge for a called third strike. Bounce right back up the middle. That's going to get by help. Running for second now is Davis, and he'll be in there standing. Oh! Leonard, how you doing?
Play ball!
Here comes Mello holding the slide.
Hey, hey!
A tedious save!
Hey, hey!
Goldeyes win it!
Hey, hey!
This is Winnipeg Goldeyes Baseball on your home of the Goldeyes. TSN 1290. TSN 1290.ca. Tonight, live from Shaw Park in downtown Winnipeg, your Winnipeg Goldeyes host, the Lincoln Saltdogs. Now, the voice of the Goldeyes, Paul Edmonds.
Last night's rainout likely helped both the Goldeyes and the Lincoln Saltdogs catch up on some much-needed rest based on the fact that both clubs had to travel overnight to get here for yesterday's Game 1 of this four-game series. But now that Mother Nature didn't allow the game to take place, the two teams will play a doubleheader tonight to make up for the lost game and get the series underway officially. Now, doubleheaders are not always a favorite of baseball teams, especially if you get swept or somehow you play extra innings and your bullpen gets overexposed. But should you be able to win both ends of the double dip, well, then it can really set you off to a solid place, especially with the rest of the series still to unfold and a chance for a series win still on the table. Which way it goes tonight, well, we'll determine over the next 14 innings or more what happens. So as we've said before many times, when there's a game in lieu, let's play two. It's the Goldeyes Saltdogs games 1 and 2 coming up next from downtown Winnipeg on the home of the Goldeyes, TSN 1290.
If insurance brokers were rated like ballplayers, Winnipeg insurance brokers would be batting 1,000. They're the pros you can count on for complete protection of your home, business, vehicles, and even that dream trip. Get free quotes and helpful tips at WinnipegInsuranceBrokers.com or visit one of their two locations. Winnipeg Insurance Brokers, helping you protect the things you love. Peace of mind starts at WinnipegInsuranceBrokers.com, a wholly owned subsidiary of Assiniboine Credit Union.
Hi, I'm Chris Walby. The Snapper rear engine riding mower is now over 50 years old. And to celebrate, Snapper is introducing all new models for 2013. That's right. The legendary Snapper rear engine rider has been reinvented, designed with today's consumer in mind. The new Snapper rear engine riders are now even easier to use, more comfortable to ride, and perform better than ever.
For a Snapper dealer near you, to see the exciting new Snapper rear engine riding mower, contact Yetman's Limited in Winnipeg.
Win a diamond at the Diamond. Presented by Free Jive Winnipeg and Bijou Jewelry. Pick up your special edition Free Jive paper at the Tuesday, July 2nd Goldeyes game. Fill out the entry form and drop it in the ballot box for your chance to win a loose diamond worth more than $2,500. Free Jive Winnipeg. Online, on site, on the street. Delivered to hundreds of restaurants and thousands of inboxes every week. For advertising info, visit freejivewinnipeg.com. Brought to you by iTech LASIK, Boston Pizza, and Herzing College.
Ah, nice day. Want a drink?
Yeah. Pass me a Pepsi.
How you doing?
Whoa. Do you hear that? Open your Pepsi.
How you doing?
That was awesome.
Hit it out of the park this summer.
How you doing?
With the cool, refreshing taste of Pepsi. Pepsi. Live for now.
Grand Slam Goldeyes coverage with Paul Edmonds. This is TSN 1290. TSN1290.ca.
Well, let's play two here tonight. Rain on last night. I don't think anybody saw that coming, really. We knew we were going to get a little bit of precipitation last night, but boy, it came rolling in, and it just stayed, and boy, did it pour, and there was weather warnings around the capital region here last night, and they made a real good call at 8:01 last night or so, about an hour after the game was supposed to be started, to not play it at all, and they'll play two here tonight. It's been overcast here for those of you that don't live in Winnipeg or southern Manitoba all day, but the rain has held off. It's a little gloomy, but it's nice in terms of temperature and weather. And we'll see what happens here tonight between the Goldeyes and the Lincoln Saltdogs. First and only visit for the Saltdogs this year to Winnipeg. It's a four-game series, two tonight, and then tomorrow and Sunday to conclude. Let's have a look at the starting lineups. They're brought to you by Lazy Boy Furniture Galleries, located at 1425 Ellis. Lazy Boy Furniture Galleries, live life comfortably. Well, it will be Matt Rush that will get the start here in game one. He was the scheduled starter for today anyway. Pete Gehle will actually go in game two. Moise Melendez will stay as the game one starter for Lincoln, and Matt Bywater will go as the game two starter. So that's the one change. And here is Matt Rush gets prepared with a 4-2 record to make the start. He'll look at a Lincoln lineup that looks like this. The Saltdogs are 19-14. The Goldeyes 17-15. Daniel Carroll will lead it off. He's in center field. Steven Douglas is the DH, and he'll bat second. David Espinosa is a switch hitting second baseman. He'll bat third. Matt Forgatch is hitting cleanup, and he's out in left. Tyler Goodrow is at first base batting fifth. Brian Embury will bat in the sixth spot and play out in right field. Mike Proventure starts the bottom three, and he'll be at third base hitting seventh. Sean O'Donnell will catch it, bat eighth. And Yasiel Gomez at short, batting ninth. That lineup again for the Lincoln Saltdogs here tonight is Carroll, Douglas the DH, Espinosa, Forgatch, Goodrow, Embury, Proventure, O'Donnell, and Gomez. Here we go. Goldeyes in a red top and a white pad here tonight. And Matt Rush will throw out the first pitch. here this evening. We'll play 14 innings, two games, and here we go as he rocks, kicks, and fires, and the first pitch is in there for a strike at 6:06 tonight. So the series officially underway 24 hours later, or 23 hours later than it was supposed to be, but underway at 6:06 Central, 6 minutes after 6 o'clock here tonight. Daniel Carroll batting 260, the pitch. Fastball swung on, bounced out toward third. It gets by Amos Ramon and into left field for a base hit. So a solid single for Daniel Carroll to start off. And our opening pitch tonight brought to you by the Greenwood Inn & Suites. Make the Greenwood Inn & Suites your home base for all your accommodation, dining, and meeting needs in Winnipeg. Call toll-free today, 888-233-6730. Here's Stephen Douglas batting 250, left-handed batter. So two pitches in, we have a base hit for Daniel Carroll. And he's over at first, being held on by Casey Arthur. Our home plate umpire tonight is Joe Pascucci. First pitch is just a little bit low, ball one. Brock Bellew is over at first, and P.J. Krause is at third base. He's the local umpire. And we'll have these gentlemen right through to the conclusion of this series on Sunday afternoon. Rush from the stretch, the 1-0, runner on the move, pitches in there for a strike. And on the transfer, Luis Allen couldn't get a good grip on the baseball, and Daniel Carroll has his 11th stolen base of the year. Uncontested at second. And a 1-1 count now on Stephen Douglas. So Pascucci calling the balls and strikes. Ballou is over at first, and Krause is at third base. Lights are on here on a overcast evening in southern Manitoba. 1-1, swung on and bounced back toward the screen. Foul, 1-2. Defensively for the Goldeyes tonight, Luis Allen doing the catching. Casey Arthur over at first, Nick Liles at second, Nate Sampson at short, Amos Ramon is at third. And then Mike Coles returns. Phelan Lentini, Josh Mazzola left to right in the outfield. Not a bad gathering to start at 6:06 tonight. It will get better as we get closer to the regular game time of 7:05. The 1-2 pitch is a fastball wide to Stephen Douglas, and it's 2-2. Goldeyes and Saltdogs are 2-2 this year against each other. The Goldeyes won the first two in Lincoln, lost the next two. And Lincoln without two of their best players. Dennis Rabin sold back to affiliated baseball, and Ian Gack is hurt. 2-2 is a changeup outside. 3-2. Nobody out. Runner at second base in Daniel Carroll. Matt Rush here tonight getting the start. It's his eighth. He's 4-2 with a 3.83 earned run average. The 3-2 pitch swung on that slider and fouled away left side. And Stephen Douglas, who has 3 homers and 19 driven in, stays alive with a full count on him. So again, the Goldeyes defensively, Allen catching, Arthur at first, Liles at second, Sampson at short, Ramon at third, and then Coles, Lentini, and Mazzola left to right in the outfield. One thing about the rainout last night, got a chance to watch that basketball game. Game 7, 3-2. Swung on, bounced down the first base line. And foul. And I know the Ramones, big Spurs fans down in Corpus Christi, a little bit disappointed by the outcome last night. I really enjoyed the game, though. It was sports at its best. And I always marvel at how they're all great players at that level, of course. But one of the best players can really put the rest of great players on his back, i.e. LeBron James, and march them to victory. 3-2. Swung on and lifted down the left field line. It'll be a foul ball. The only question is, can Coles get there? And he cannot. And it bounces foul. Stays on the playing surface. And Coles will flip it into the seats. 3-2 to Stephen Douglas. When Tim Bryant missed that layup or that drive through the paint and the putback after the initial miss, and they didn't get a chance to tie that game last night, and possession went back to the Heat with a 2-point lead, I knew it was over. Three balls and two strikes to Stephen Douglas. Runner at second base. Nobody out. And Rush will come set. And the pitch. Fastball swung on and fouled back. We've been at this for five full minutes already, and Matt Rush has seen two batters. Field is in excellent shape. Of course, the tarp was on the field before the rain came last night. Three balls, two strikes. And the pitch swung on, and that's popped up into shallow left. Back goes Sampson, the shortstop, and he'll get underneath it and make the catch for the first out. Good at bat there for Stephen Douglas. Nothing to show for it. Good battle. And here's David Espinosa, who will bat from the left side as a switch hitter against the righty and Matt Rush. Rush comes in having worked 44 and two-thirds innings, allowing 41 hits, 19 earned runs, 10 walks, 33 strikeouts, four homers in the opposition batting 244 against him. And Rush leans over to get the sign. Comes set. Checks Carroll at second base. First pitch. Change up. Swung on and missed. Espinosa way out in front of that. Coming up between games, we'll keep it here, and we will have a feature interview with Ryan Skoma tonight. Find out about his injury, how he's doing, playing in Rockland last year, coming to Winnipeg, being a former San Francisco Giant farmhand. The 0-1 runner on the move, pitches in there for ball one. Throw down to third, not in time. And Stephen Carroll has his second stolen base of the night and his 12th of the year. And that is the third time in the last three games the Goldeyes have allowed a steal of third. Happened twice, actually on Wednesday night in St. Paul. One ball, one strike. The pitch swung on, bounced down the first base line. Diving stop behind the bag by Arthur, gets up off his chest. And he'll take it to the base himself, but Daniel Carroll, based on a couple steals, will score easily from third, and Lincoln has the early lead at 1-0. Great play by Casey Arthur, though. An unassisted play and a diving stop behind the bag, then the race to the bag as he got to his feet, and he won that. But I'll tell you what, Daniel Carroll, a base hit, stealing second, stealing third, coming in to score, kind of himself, got himself on, got himself over, and got a little help getting in from David Espinosa, who picks up his 13th RBI of the year. First pitch to Matt Forgach is a slider, swung on and missed for strike one. So two away and a run in for the Lincoln Saltdogs. The 0-1 is another slider. That's outside. One ball, one strike. And for the second straight game, the opposition scores first on Winnipeg. As St. Paul did on Wednesday, 1-1 is high with a fastball, 2-1. Two balls and one strike to Forgach, batting 249. The 2-1 pitch. Slider swung on and missed. Good tight one there. And it's 2-2. As a team, this Lincoln team is batting 259. By comparison, the Goldeyes hitting 282. And yet, they've got 19 wins and 14 losses. It's the pitching staff that's been very good. When you talk to people around the Lincoln Saltdogs. And Ken Obergfeldt has done a real good job here. 2-2. Breaking ball, swung on and missed. Strikeout number one for Matt Rush tonight. And that first strikeout is brought to you by Manitoba Hydro. Manitoba Hydro reminds you to be safe around electricity. Folks, one strike, and you're out. Lincoln opens up the scoring. They get a run on a hit. Two stolen bases help out. Nobody left. They get one. The Goldeyes are coming to bat in a seven-inning game when we come back on TSN 1290.
I'm Larry McIntosh. Did you know that peak-of-the-market vegetables are grown in Manitoba? Well, they are. 100% Manitoba grown, with no exceptions. Peak of the Market's Manitoba family farms are all located within 100 miles of Winnipeg. Peak of the Market, always local and proud of it.
The very best from Manitoba, it's Peak of the Market.
Selkirk Chrysler's massive factory-authorized truck sale is on now. Find a huge selection of 2013 Ram pickups, quad cab, crew cab, regular cab, gas, diesel. We have them, and they're on sale. Savings up to 17 grand with super low financing, like the quad cab 4x4 with new 8-speed automatic transmission featuring an incredible 33 miles per gallon at just $169 biweekly. Only at Selkirk Chrysler's factory-authorized truck sale. Details at selkirkchrysler.com.
This is about your debt rescue. It's about climbing free of creditors and saving for the future. It's about someone reaching out to you, helping you regain your financial foothold with credit proposals and other options. And it's about changing the way you save and spend so your debt worries are far behind you. It's about your debt rescue with LC Taylor, Trustees in Bankruptcy. Your way forward at lctaylor.com.
Bottom of the first inning. My name is Paul Edmonds. Alex Albany is our producer and operator back at our studios in South Winnipeg. And Brendan McGranahan, super student, helping us out on site. 1-0 Lincoln. Goldeyes will go to work in the bottom of the first. Scheduled for seven, then a break, then seven more in game two tonight. Mike Coles to lead it off. Welcome back, Michael. First pitch. He is in there for a strike from Moise Melendez. It's Coles, Ramon, and Mazzola. Then Harther, Davis the DH, Lentini, Alen, Liles, Sampson. Pitch is swung on and lined down the right field line. Fair ball. It's going to skip into the corner. Extra bases for Coles. He digs for second and will be in standing. Welcome home, Michael Coles, with a leadoff double. Just went the other way with a pitch. And the Goldeyes have the potential tie and run into scoring position here in the bottom of this first inning. And here's Amos Ramon. And Amos will stand in for the right side. Defensively tonight for Lincoln, Sean O'Donnell, the other half of the battery. As Melendez comes set, first pitch. Fastballs outside, ball one. Tyler Goodrow over at first. David Espinosa is at second. Yusel Gomez at short. Mike Preventure at third base. And then Matt Forgatch, Daniel Carroll, and Brian Emberry. Left to right in the outfield. For game one of this doubleheader, game one of this series, the 1-0 is high. Two balls and no strikes. Amos leads the team with 21 walks this year. Very good eye. And a 407 on base percentage. 2-0. In there for a strike, and it's 2-1. So again, O'Donnell catching for game one. Goodrow at first. Espinosa is at second. Gomez at short. Preventure at third. Forgatch, Carroll, and Emberry. Left to right in the outfield. The lefty, Melendez, will come set. The 2-1 is a fastball on the outside edge for a strike, and it's 2-2. Amos hitting 284. He was 1 for 12 in that series against St. Paul. 0 for 5 on Wednesday night. 1-0 Lincoln, runner at second, nobody out. The 2-2. Breaking ball, swung on and fouled back into the mitt of the catcher, O'Donnell, and that's strikeout number one for Melendez. And here is Josh Mazzola. Mazzola broke out of an 0 for 10 slump in St. Paul with a home run. And Josh will stand in from the right side. Four home runs, 14 driven in. And Melendez comes set. First pitch. Fastball wide, ball one. Here in Winnipeg, it's overcast, 22 degrees Celsius. That translates to 71 degrees Fahrenheit. Humidity is fairly high, 76%. Northeast wind at 13 from left to right here this evening. And a pickoff attempt got thrown right into center field. And up with the ball is Carroll. His throw will go to third, but it will be tardy as Coles is in standing at third on the air to the pitcher, Melendez. So first error of the night will be E1 on the pickoff attempt, and Melendez just fired into center field. And the Goldeyes are 90 feet away from tying this up. 1-0 Lincoln. And Josh Mazzola, 2-for-12 in that series against St. Paul, but both hits came on Wednesday night, including a home run. Melendez will come set, and the 1-0 pitch is a little bit low, 2-0. Again, 22 Celsius, 71 Fahrenheit here tonight. Wind is not much of a factor, a little bit from left to right. 2-0. Breaking ball in there for a strike, and it's 2-1. Hard to tell whether the ball will have much carry tonight with humidity. Haven't really had a ball hit to the outfield yet. 2-1. Breaking ball is low and maybe a little bit outside, 3-1. Now, of course, Coles had the double, but that was more of a line drive. I'm talking about a fly ball. Ones that usually come off this guy's bat here, Josh Mazzola. 3-1. Inside, ball four. So Mazzola will draw a walk. And there'll be runners on the corners for Casey Harther. And Harther, 3-for-12 against St. Paul earlier this week. Batting 3-11. Leads the team in home runs with 6. And with 20 RBI. And Harther will step in now back out as Sean O'Donnell, the catcher here for the Salt Dogs, steps in front of home plate and flashes some signs. And Melendez will come set. First pitch is high and away, ball one. If you're wondering, Melendez has given up one home run this year in the 29 and two-thirds innings that he's worked. And now Melendez and O'Donnell will want to have a little chat. And now O'Donnell back to set up behind home plate. Goldeyes as a team have hit 26 home runs. Lincoln's hit 33. Melendez comes set. The 1-0 is in there for a strike, and it's 1-1. Took something off of that. Goldeyes entering this game have lost 2 in a row. And they've lost 2 in a row to Lincoln. 1-1. Swung on and fouled off the catcher. And Sean O'Donnell felt that. And the home plate umpire, Joe Piscucci, will go personally and deliver the baseball out to Melendez to buy a little bit of time for Sean O'Donnell to shake that foul back off. One ball, two strikes to Harther. He was 0-for-4 on Wednesday night. Right-handed batter. One ball, two strikes. Melendez comes set, and the pitch, breaking ball, swung on and fouled back into the seats behind that Salt Dogs first base dugout. One ball, two strikes still to Harther. Runners on the corners, Coles at third, and Mazzola at first. Rick Forney coaching over at third, Tom Vaith at first base. Melendez comes set, 1-2 pitch. Breaking ball, swung on, bounced out towards short. Diving out, Gomez can't come up with it. It goes back through the box for a base hit. And a run-scoring single at that. And Harther drives in his 21st, and we're tied at one. Well, didn't know diving to his left if Gomez was going to get to that. It somehow got past him. As a, I think it went underneath his glove or arm. And a good at bat for Casey Harther. The Goldeyes have tied it. Stopping at second is Mazzola. And we're locked at one here. And Leonard Davis, the DH, is the batter. Leonard on a five-game hitting streak. First pitch is high, ball one. He was 3-for-14 in the series against St. Paul. Had a home run, a two-run shot that tied it on Wednesday night at 3 before the Goldeyes lost in the bottom of 9. 1-0. He is in there for a strike, and it's 1-1. Leonard batting 262. And the way he has swung the bat in the last four or so games, you're starting to think that he might be getting close to getting hot. 1-1. Breaking ball, swung on and fouled to the plate. One ball, two strikes. One out, one in, two on. And a 1-1 tie. Leonard with 4 home runs and 15 driven in. One ball, two strikes. And the pitch. Swing and a miss. Chased a breaking ball well out of the strike zone. Got fooled on that. Strikeout number 2 here for Melendez. And the batter is Faye Lantini. And Faye was 5-for-14 in the series against St. Paul. So he had a real good little visit to Minnesota, where he's hitting .357 currently. And batting .306 on the year. First pitch is outside, ball one. Mazzola at second, Harther at first. And a 1-1 tie. Game 2, Pete Gehle versus Matt Bywater. 1-0. Swung on, and that is lined right side by Espinosa into right field. They're going to wave in Mazzola. Here comes the throw. It will be cut off by the first baseman in Goodrow. Mazzola will slide in safely on the RBI single by Lentini. It's back-to-back run scoring hits for Winnipeg by the middle of the order. And they lead it 2-1. And Luis Allen, the batter. First to third goes Harther. So the Goldeyes run the bases well there. And Lentini drives into 16th, and it's 2-1 Winnipeg. And Luis Allen will stand in from the right side. Speaking of good series in Minnesota, first pitch, breaking ball is in there for a strike. Al Cabong was just that in Minnesota. He was 6-for-11, was Louis. .545 against the Saints is his batting average this year so far. The 0-1 is outside. One ball, one strike. And that helped up his average to .324. One ball, one strike. The pitch. Breaking ball, swung on, bounced right side, rolled right up there to Espinosa. Second baseman up with it and over to first, and the Goldeyes are done. Sending 7 to the plate, scoring twice. They do that on 3 hits, and they leave a pair. At the end of 1, scheduled for 7, Winnipeg 2, Lincoln 1. On TSN 1290.
Be a part of history as the Winnipeg Blue Bombers play their first season at the awesome Investors Group Field. The home opener is June 27th, and before the game, make sure to stop by the Ponies for some free game fun. And remember, you can park and ride to each game with the Pony Express Shuttle Service. No tickets? No problem. Purchase any Budweiser product at any Pony location and you could win tickets. Or catch the action on the Ponies HD screens. They'll have hot specials on wings, ribbies, and plenty of cold drinks. The Pony Corral, proudly celebrating 25 years.
Did you know that water makes up more than half of your body weight? Every cell, tissue, and organ in your body needs water to maintain its temperature, remove waste, and lubricate joints. Culligan's filtered bottled water delivered right to your door is the best choice for hydration.
Call or click today to enjoy Culligan bottled water service for as little as $21.75 a month. Just call 204-694-5180 or visit drinkculligan.com. Culligan, better water, pure and simple. Limited time offer. Dealer participation may vary. See dealer for details.
Now, I'm not afraid to take risks under the perfect ideal conditions, but when it comes to pizza, I'll stick with Santa Lucia pizza. I mean, why risk getting anything less than Santa Lucia, voted best pizza in Winnipeg by Uptown Magazine readers for 6 straight years and winner of the Consumer Choice Award for best pizza restaurant for 7 years? I mean, after all, this is pizza we're talking about.
Don't risk ordinary pizza. Get Winnipeg's best at Santa Lucia Pizza. Dine in, take out, or home delivery.
You see, the best ingredients make the best pizza.
You're listening to Goldeyes Baseball with Paul Edmonds on TSN 1290.
TSN1290.ca.
Well, we go to inning number two, and it's 2-1 for Winnipeg, scheduled for 7, and when they're done, they'll take a break for about 20 minutes and then play game number two tonight. Tyler Goodrow to lead it off, followed by Brian Emberry and Mike Preventure. 5, 6, and 7 in the order for Lincoln. And Goodrow batting .293. Matt Rush works into his second. First pitch. Swung on, nubbed off the end of the bat. Foul. Goodrow, no homers and 9 driven in. This is game 11 for Tyler Goodrow with the Lincoln Saltdogs from Omaha, Nebraska. Pitch is swung on and fouled back again. He was previously with the Joliet Slammers of the Frontier League. Always enjoyed going to Joliet. You know, they always had good crowds. They had a great ballpark. They were far enough from Chicago where the team had some identity in the community. The 0-2. Breaking ball is low. 1-2. But yet, you know, if you wanted to be in downtown Chicago, you could be there in about 35 minutes. With good traffic, of course. 1-2. And the pitch. Breaking ball, swung on and fouled away. By the way, folks, drop into Home Run Sports at De La Seigneurie Boulevard. Bishop Grandin entered a win in the Home Run Sports home run inning. Here's how it works. If a Goldeye player hits a home run in any inning, and we pick your name that day, you'll receive an Easton prize package courtesy of Easton Sports. 1-2 pitch is just inside, 2-2. But you must hear your name on this program in order to know that you're a winner. And afterward, you must contact Home Run Sports within 30 days to claim your prize. You can do that in person or by calling 255-768-7. 2-2. Breaking ball, half a swing. Did he go? The appeal at first, and Brock Ballou says no, he did not. 3-2. Well, there was a couple of home runs hit on Wednesday night. Josh Mazzola, his 4th, a solo shot to get the Goldeyes on the board in that loss, 4-3 in the bottom of the 9th inning to St. Paul. And Leonard Davis tied it at 3 with his 4th, 3-2. Fouled the plate. We do it again. It was a 2-run shot in the 8th inning. And both of them, Mazzola and Davis, hitting their 4th of the year. So we have 2 winners on the Home Run Sports home run inning. We have Jay Dunn and Ryan Oakley. The payoff pitch. Breaking ball, swung on and fouled away. Right side, sky sweep. To my right. Still 3-2 here to Tyler Goodrow. So Jay Dunn and Ryan Oakley, you are our winners tonight on the Home Run Sports home run inning. You've got 30 days to contact Home Run Sports to claim your prize. Now the payoff pitch. Swung on, line to center. That's well smoked. Lentini going back, still going back, and it is off the base of the wall. Lentini tried to barehand it, missed it. Now he'll pick it up and fire it in, but it will be a stand-up double for Tyler Goodrow, and he leads off after a good at-bat against Matt Rush with the potential tying run into scoring position. And his team's second hit and their first for extra bases tonight. And Brian Emberry, the batter. He's another switch hitter. He'll bat from the left side. This is game four for him. By the way, Ian Gack, who was a one-man wrecking crew in the last two games of that four-game series in May between the Goldeyes and Saltdogs, broke his hand, and he's out for about 4 weeks. First pitch, fastball on the outside edge for a strike. He's back home in Seattle, and he'll rejoin the team when he gets a little bit closer to being healthy. The 0-1 is high and away. One ball, one strike. 2-1, the Goldeyes lead it. We're in the top of the second. Leadoff man for the second straight inning against Matt Rush gets aboard. Brian Emberry batting 200. 1-1. Change up is just outside, 2-1. So that's the story on Ian Gack. He'll be back, but is on the disabled list now with that broken hand. That takes out one of the best hitters in that Lincoln lineup. Plus, they lost Dennis Rabin, who was sold back to affiliated baseball. Pitch is swung on and fouled back. 2-2. Plus, they lost Joe Bassinius, who was just sold a couple days ago to the Atlanta Braves. So, it was a good pitcher and two good hitters. Two balls and two strikes to Emberry. Pitch, fastball, just missed inside, 3-2. Boy, I'll tell you what, Matt Rush is not missing by much. Got a good veteran umpire back there, too. 3-2. Swung on, chopper right side. Liles is there, fields it, throws to first. One away. And the batter, Mike Preventer. So, runner advances to third. And Preventer the batter. 2-1 Winnipeg in front. And I think we're almost trying to have the sun pop out here. Got a little bit brighter as we've got into this one. First pitch. Breaking ball on the outside edge for a strike. And more folks will be making their way into the ballpark. As, like I said, we get closer to 7:05, which is the normal game time for a Friday night game. Nothing and one to Preventure. The pitch is in there for another strike. Preventure didn't like it, thought it was a little bit high. Nothing and two. Don't forget, tomorrow we're on the air at 4:30 around the association. Bob Elliott from the Toronto Sun will join us to talk about the Blue Jays. Boy, they've been hot lately. And also about the Canadians that were drafted recently in the Major League Draft. The 0-2 is outside with a breaking ball. One ball, two strikes. And the plan is we're also going to talk to now setup man, but was for the last couple of years the closer for Lincoln, P.J. Zocchi. He'll be a guest with us tomorrow as well. One ball, two strikes. And the pitch. Swung on, ground ball, out towards short, to his left. Sampson up with it, on to first. The run will score to tie it up at two. So again, Get them on, get them over, and get them in. An RBI here on a ground ball for Mike Provencher. And Sean O'Connell, the batter. And O'Connell batting 189. He's the pancake batter tonight. And he'll stand in from the left side. First pitch is in there for a strike. O'Connell, no homers and four driven in. This is game 17, but he's had 53 at-bats. 0-1 is inside, one ball, one strike. Two away, one in. We're tied at two, top of two. O'Donnell batting eighth in the order. Rush operating from the full line. The 1-1 pitch is low. Two balls and one strike with that change of pace.
Once again, and hit, and hit.
After this series is done on Sunday, the Goldeyes will travel on Monday. Open up on Tuesday in Sioux City. The pitch, swing and a miss, and it's 2-2. Three-game series there in the first visit to Iowa. And then they will skip on over toward Chicagoland for three and the only visit to Gary and then home. And that ends the June schedule and essentially begins July. Two balls and two strikes. The pitch. Cole, third strike on the outside corner. Great fastball at 91 of the gun here. And Rush will pick up his second strikeout of the night. Everybody picks up free flapjacks. And Lincoln, though, picks up a run to tie it. A run on a hit, nobody left. We'll go to the bottom of two. We'll play some trivia. Lincoln scored in two straight. The Goldeyes will try to do that as well when we return. TSN 1290.
The Winnipeg Goldeyes make dreams come true by providing live baseball experiences to charities, nonprofit groups, and inner city programs. Now, with the Goldeyes Community Zone, you can make even more memories. For group tickets, contact the Goldeyes at 982-BASE. These extra seats are only possible through generous donations from the Community Zone partners. So, from the Winnipeg Goldeyes and Community Zone recipients, thank you. John Henry Creations, Investors Group, CarStar Automotive and Manitoba Lotteries Corporation. CIBC and the Winnipeg Goldeyes have partnered to fight cancer. On Sunday, October 6th, CIBC and Goldeyes employees, friends, and family will be running in Winnipeg for a future without breast cancer. Shaw Park, home of your Winnipeg Goldeyes, will host the Canadian Breast Cancer Foundation CIBC Run for the Cure. For more information, to register to run, or to make a donation, go online to CIBC.com. Let's run for a future without breast cancer. Join in on Sunday, October 6th at Shaw Park.
It's 4:30 a.m. The city is fast asleep, except for a few early risers, working behind the scenes, getting things ready for the day, picking up what's left behind. Johnson Waste Management. Doing our best to be the very best.
Nick Liles will lead it off. Bottom of two, Liles, Sampson, and Coles. 8-9-1 against Moise Melendez. In a 2-2 tie here. Game one of a doubleheader tonight. Both games scheduled for 7. You know, earlier this week, Gary and Wichita played a split doubleheader, and Joe Piscucci is getting right into the grill here of Sean O'Donnell, the catcher here. And I don't know what that was all about. And Tyler Goodrow came down the line as well from first base. I don't know what that was about. All I heard was Piscucci say to Goodrow, to O'Donnell after O'Donnell had taken off his mask, do you want to continue or do you want to finish this game? First pitch is in there for a strike to Nick Liles. The 0-1. swung on and fell back to the screen. Nothing in two. Somebody had told me, and this is the first time we've seen Joe Piscucci this year work a series involving the Goldeyes, that he settled down. He's mellowed down a little bit. I don't know. 0-2. Breaking ball is high. 1-2. One thing when you get a Joe Piscucci crew or when he's working the dish, there won't be a lot of barking. He is in control of the game. 1-2. Swung on, and that is a flare out towards second that's caught by Espinosa. And Nick Liles will be out number one. And here is Nate Sampson. And Sampson will stride up from the right-hand side. Let's play trivia here in the bottom of two. And trivia contest question brought to you by the Place Louis Riel Suite Hotel in downtown Winnipeg. Place Louis Riel specializing in spacious executive suites. First pitch. And a bunt is pushed foul, and it will land over by that Salt Dogs dugout. And the count, strike one. Sampson, 5-for-13 with a couple of RBI, a couple of runs scored in that series. Against St. Paul. Batting 205. The 0-1 from Melendez. Breaking ball in there for a strike. Nothing in two. Again, so trivia brought to you by the Place Louis Riel Suite Hotel in downtown Winnipeg. Place Louis Riel specializing in spacious executive suites. First of two questions on the night. The pitch, fastball swung on, line to center. That will drop for a base hit. Boy, I'll tell you what. If you're a pitcher, you're the catcher or the manager, you don't really want to have that happen too often. In fact, when that scenario unfolds, you get pretty upset with yourself. You got ahead with a changeup and a breaking ball at 0-2. Then you come back fastball, and the guy lines it right back up the middle for a base hit. Not only fastball, but right down the middle. Rick will always say, you get to two strikes, try to expand the zone so that doesn't happen. Maybe he'll chase. As Mike Cole steps in, first pitch, and he showed bunt, pulled back, took outside, ball one. Maybe he'll chase the pitch and do some work for you that way to get himself out. Good piece of hitting by Nate Sampson. Fourth hit for Winnipeg, a one-out single. We're tied at two apiece here in the bottom of two. 1-0 is high, two balls and no strikes. And for the first time here tonight, if you've won already, we will let you back in. Welcome back. Well, we'll do it in terms of the last 30 days. If you haven't won in the last 30 days, you're welcome back in. If you have, well, you're going to have to wait the appropriate amount of time. 2-0 is high. Three balls and no strikes. Coles tonight, 1-for-1, a run scored. He doubled to lead off. Three balls, no strikes. Melendez comes, set the pitch. Fastball on the outside edge for a strike, and it's 3-1. So the contest is open to those that haven't won in the last 30 days. Up for grabs a pair of Goldeye tickets to a future home game. You'll also be eligible to win the grand prize of a weekend stay at the Place Louis at the end of the season. Number to call, 204-780-1290, if you think you know the answer tonight. 204-780-1290. Three balls, one strike. The pitch swung on and inside and outed, and it went right into that Lincoln bench, caught with one hand by one of their players. And into the seats it goes for a souvenir. Nice grab, even better gesture. 3-2 to Coles. Nate Sampson, if you're wondering, 1-for-2 on the base paths. Goldeyes as a team have swiped 34 bases. By comparison, Lincoln has 39. Three balls, two strikes to Mike Coles. And a throw goes over to first, and Sampson walks back in safely. Question tonight is this, the first of two questions tonight. The game one question, I guess, is the better way to say it. The Goldeyes have been involved in five walk-off wins this season. Five. 3-2. Runner on the move. Pitch is swung on and missed. Throw down to second. And that will be it for the Goldeyes, as a good throw there by O'Connell to Gomez, the shortstop. He was waiting for Sampson at the base. And it's a strike him out, throw him out. Double play. So that will end the second in a 2-2 tie. We'll go to the third. We'll give you the last part of the question when we come back. The actual question when we return in a 2-2 tie on TSN 1290.
It's furniture that has a story to tell. Discover the unrivaled character and craftsmanship only Manitoba Made can offer with Prairie Barnwood. Prairie Barnwood specializes in handcrafted furniture and decor made from dismantled barns from across the Canadian prairies. From mantels to countertops, furniture, even custom pieces, it's all made in Manitoba. See these one-of-a-kind works of art for yourself. Learn more about Manitoba Reclaimed Barnwood Furniture today at prairiebarnwood.com.
You love your steak, but what else do you really know about it? If you believe the redder the meat, the fresher it is, or that shipping it from across the world is best, it's time for re-education. Learn what quality really means from your beef specialist, the Carver's Knife. All of their quality beef comes from local farmers, and it's properly aged to bring out the best flavor. Once you try a Carver's Knife steak, there's no going back. Know your meat and where it comes from. Get educated at the Carver's Knife, 1530 Regent Avenue West, and now open at 39 Marion Street in the Dominion Center Mall.
On July 4th, 1939, Lou Gehrig gave his final farewell to his fans at Yankee Stadium. On Saturday, June 22nd, the Winnipeg Goldeyes and the ALS Society of Manitoba will host ALS Lou Gehrig's Night. Join us at Shaw Park as we pay tribute to this baseball hero and at the same time help to battle the disease that affects the lives of more than 260 Manitobans and their families. Join us for ALS Lou Gehrig's Night and enjoy a fun night of great Goldeyes baseball while supporting the ALS Society of Manitoba.
You're listening to Goldeyes Baseball on TSN 1290, TSN1290.ca. Brought to you in part by South Beach Casino. Like it, love it.
Well, we go to the third inning. Yasiel Gomez is the leadoff hitter here in this inning for Lincoln, and he looks at a strike from Matt Rush in a 2-2 tie here. It's Gomez, Carroll, and Douglas, the DH. The 0-1. Breaking ball, bounced out towards short, tough play. Running backhanded pickup there by Sampson. Thought about throwing it, but ended up kind of going halfway through the motion and realizing he wasn't going to get Gomez, who will get an infield single. And for the third straight inning, the leadoff man is aboard for Lincoln. And their third hit. And here's Daniel Carroll, who's 1-for-1. Two stolen bases already in the game and a run scored in this 2-2 tie. We're playing trivia. Got to give you the other half of the question and let you play along. If you haven't won in the last 30 days, you're eligible. Goldeyes have been involved in five walk-off wins this season. First pitch is on the outside edge for a strike. What is their record in those five games? .204-780-1290 if you think you know the answer. What's the Goldeyes record in the five walk-off wins that they've been involved in this year? Throw down to first base and not in time. Gomez, somebody missed a signal there. I don't know if Gomez was supposed to go. If it was a hit and run, it's a strike there to Daniel Carroll, the count 1-1. But then Gomez kind of got out into no man's land there and was lucky to get back to first base on the snap throw by Luis Allen. One ball, one strike. We're tied at two, and Rush will come set. The pitch swung on, fouled away right side. And it's a ball and two strikes. One ball, two strikes. We'll have a look at the out-of-town scoreboard here in this third. And we have a winner on trivia. Caller number three tonight. Congratulations. Winner of the answer coming up in around the seventh. Pitch is swung on, bounced out toward third, but foul. And Daniel Carroll will stay alive in a ball and two strikes. One ball, two strikes. Daniel Carroll hitting 260. Right-handed batter. Nobody out, runner at first. Rush comes set to his chest, and the pitch. Breaking ball swung on and fouled back. And a bluff over there by Yasiel Gomez as well. Daniel Carroll, four home runs, 14 driven in. We're tied at two. Culligan in-game line score looks like this for Culligan Water. Better water, pure and simple. Contact them at drinkculligan.com. Runner bluffs, pitches outside, throw down to first again. Back in time again is Gomez. Two runs, four hits for Winnipeg. Two runs, three hits, and an error for Lincoln. Two and two to Daniel Carroll. And Rush comes set, and a throw over to first, and hopping back in with a long stride there is Gomez safely at first base. Lots of games going on in the majors. Everything in the American Association is at seven or later. Pitch is swung on and popped up to left field. In comes Mike Coles. Back goes Sampson. Sampson, the shortstop underneath it, will make the catch for the first out. And here's Stephen Douglas. Third inning tonight. The Yankees are leading Tampa Bay 1-0 in New York. Cleveland ahead of Minnesota, 1-0. That's in the third inning. And Toronto leading Baltimore 2-1. Helped along by a home run from Adam Lind, his 10th. J.J. Hardy has smacked his 15th to account for the Orioles' lone run. Adam Lind is hitting almost 400 in the month of June. 3 points shy at 397. First pitch to Douglas. Runner on the move. Pitch is swung on and fouled away down the left field line. Look out. Strike one on Stephen Douglas. And because Adam Lind didn't start the year with the Blue Jays, his .340 batting average would be good enough for third overall in the American League, but he doesn't have enough plate appearances to qualify. The 0-1 is an off-speed pitch in there for a strike to Stephen Douglas, and it's nothing in two. Third inning tonight, Detroit and Boston are tied at one. Shane Victorino, a home run to account for the Red Sox lone run. Nothing in two to Stephen Douglas. Throw over to first base and Gomez back in time. Andrew Bailey, by the way, for you Red Sox fans, has been replaced by Koji Uehara as Boston's closer. Bailey has blown three of the last five save opportunities. Another pickoff attempt over at first, and again Gomez with one away here in the inning. Back in time. We're in the third. Tied at two. 7-10 tonight. Chicago at Kansas City. Hector Santiago 2-5 for the White Sox. Jeremy Guthrie 7-4 for the Royals. Runner on the move, pitches outside, throw down to second, is going to be in time. Great throw by Alen. Almost a partial pitch out there for the Goldeyes. I don't know if they wanted to or if that's where the pitch just ended up, but it worked in their favor. A caught stealing that goes 2-4. And there's two away, nobody on. And a 1-2 count now on Douglas. Yeah, the pitch was outside, easy to handle for Luis Alen. And a great throw. Liles is waiting for Gomez to slide into his glove. But it almost like a partial, almost looked like a partial pitch out for Winnipeg. 1-2. Swung on and fouled away down that left field line. And still, Stephen Douglas, who's 0-1 this evening, stays alive at a ball and two strikes. 9-10 tonight, Oakland at Seattle. Bartolo Colon 9-2. And for Seattle, Hisashi Iwakuma 7-2. Interleague game tonight, Pittsburgh at Los Angeles to take on the Angels, the 1-2. Breaking ball swung on, hit to center field. Back goes Lentini, and he will turn and face us. Backpedal the last two steps and make the catch. Steven Douglas is retired on a fly ball to dead central. No runs, one hit, nobody left. We'll go to the bottom of three. Lincoln and Winnipeg are tied at one, or tied at two on TSN 1290.
When you finally decide on the perfect paint color, the last thing you want is someone inexperienced painting in your house. Trust the experts. Trust Cachet Painting. For over 28 years, they've perfected their craft right here in Winnipeg. No job is too small or big. Interior or exterior. Primers, sealers, and finishes. Even stucco coating and painting. Cachet Painting excels at it all. Call 204-297-9000 now. Cachet Painting. A sign of superior quality.
It's summer, the perfect time to kick back and relax with friends and family. This summer, make it easy on yourself with catering by Chicken Delight. From a feast for a few to feeding your whole crew, Chicken Delight will put a smile on everyone's face with their famous chicken, fabulous pizza, ribs that rock, and more. Pick it up or have it delivered. Give us a call or send us your catering order at chickendelight.com.
So don't cook tonight.
Tonight, all right.
Call Chicken Delight.
In the world of PowerSmart, small changes add up. Did you know planting shrubs and trees around your house can shade your windows in summer and can help protect your house from chilly winter winds? Drafty windows are uncomfortable and waste energy. Sealing and re-weather stripping your windows and adding window insulator kits are an effective way to save energy and money while improving the comfort of your home. For more energy-saving solutions from Manitoba Hydro, log on to manitobapowersmart.ca.
We are tied at two. We go to the bottom of three. Glad to have you along. My name is Paul Edmonds. Alex Albany is our operator and on site being supported by Brendan McGranahan. First pitch to Amos Ramon is outside. Ball one. We are tied at two. Bottom three. Scheduled for seven in game one. 1-0 is in there for a strike, and it's 1-1. Moise Melendez works into his third. He is a product of Venezuela. 1-1 is high, 2-1. Talking about the interleague game tonight, Pittsburgh at Los Angeles to take on the Angels. Garrett Cole getting the start for the Bucs. He's 2-0. 2-1. Swung on, that's hit high. Out to left center. Daniel Carroll is going to get there and wait for it to fall down into his glove about three-quarters of the way back in the gap. And there's one away as he makes the catch. And Josh Mazzola, the batter, he's walked and scored. And Jared Weaver counters for the Angels. He's 1-3. And some interleague action in National League ballparks. A game underway. The Chicago Cubs in the eighth inning, leading Houston 3-1. First pitch is on the outside edge for a strike. Darwin Barney, Anthony Rizzo, Scott Hairston have all homered for the Cubbies. The pitch swung on and fouled to the plate, nothing in two. For Barney is fourth, Rizzo his 11th, Hairston is sixth. Chris Carter is accounted for the only run for Houston, his 15th home run. 0-2, breaking ball is low, one ball, two strikes. So four runs in that game. Chicago leads Houston 3-1 in the eighth. All four runs have come in on solo home runs. And the other interleague game in a National League ballpark tonight, starting at 7:15, Texas and St. Louis. 1-2. Outside, 2-2. Derek Holland, 4-5 for the Rangers. Tyler Lyons, 2-3 for the Cardinals. 2-2. Swung on, pulled down that left field line. Foul. Or as Jack Buck would say, Tyler Lyons, 2-3 for the Cardinals. Third inning tonight. Philadelphia leads New York, that being the Mets, 3-0. For you history buffs, Philadelphia pitcher Jim Bunning threw a perfect game on this day back in 1964 against the Metropolitans. The pitch swung on, fouled away right side. And Mazzola stays alive. The sun has popped out here. And it's a factor now on the field. Shadows are about halfway over the home plate circle. 2-2 is called third strike in the inside corner. And Mazzola will go down looking. Fourth strikeout for Melendez. And Casey Harther, the batter. And Harther, 1-for-1 with an RBI tonight. And this is his second at bat. By the way, tonight, today, is the longest day of the year. First pitch is on the outside edge for a strike. Longest day of the year, June 21st. The 0-1 is outside, 1-1. If I remember from my schooling days, today would be the summer solstice. 1-1. Swung on, fouled back. It's not an equinox because we don't have equal day and night in terms of light and darkness. So it's the solstice. Process of elimination. Pitch is low. 2-2. Did very well in geography, history, English. Math and the sciences were a little bit different. 2-2. Swung on, ground ball right side. To his right is Espinosa. Picks it up and turns and fires, going against the grain of his body. And a strike to first base at that, and that is that for Harther. Real nice play by David Espinosa on a ground ball going to his right. And he gets it there. The Goldeyes go 1-2-3, and three are in the books here. We'll go to the fourth. We're tied at 2 on TSN 1290.
Support your own. The Goldeyes and Fort Garry Brewing. Located right here in Winnipeg, Fort Garry Brewing is Manitoba's number one brewery, crafting a full spectrum of delicious beers and ales, including the award-winning Fort Garry Dark, fan-favorite Fort Garry Pale, and team-inspired Angry Fish Pilsner. All are available at Shaw Park. So cheer on the home team. Fort Garry Brewing, Manitoba made, Manitoba's own.
You're tired of waking up each day with the aches and pains of daily life. Looking for a proven solution to ease your suffering, not another drug that temporarily masks the pain? You need to get on the road to recovery, and you need a treatment that will address the cause of your pain. Manitoba chiropractors are available without the wait, and your care is partially covered by Manitoba Health and most private insurance plans.
Manitoba chiropractors, making life better.
Tammy spends most days online friending, but today she's working in the camera section at a department store. Tammy knows about tagging pictures, not taking pictures.
An f-stop? What's that?
Why buy a camera from Tammy when you can buy from Don's? At Don's Photo, you'll find a better camera at a better price. Plus, answers to all your camera questions. Minus this.
Here's another pic of me in the mirror.
Visit donsphoto.com or one of their three Winnipeg stores and let's talk photography.
First pitch to final call. Catch every minute of Goldeyes action on TSN 1290. TSN1290.ca.
All right, go to the fourth inning. David Espinosa, who made that fine play to end the bottom of three and throw Casey Harther out at first base, will lead it off. He had a 2-2 tie. It's Espinosa, Forgatch, and Goodrow. First pitch from Rush. Change up is outside, ball one. Third inning tonight, Colorado leading Washington on the Manitoba Blue Cross out-of-town scoreboard. 1-0. The 1-0 is in there for a strike. It's 1-1. 7-10 tonight, so underway in about a minute. Atlanta at Milwaukee. At 8:40 tonight, Cincinnati at Arizona. Pitches outside, 2-1. 9-10, the Dodgers in San Diego. Clayton Kershaw versus Clayton Richard in that one. And at 9:15 tonight, Miami and San Francisco, 2-1. Swing and a miss, and it's 2-2. Good fastball there. Espinoso for one tonight with an RBI. Ricky Nolasco for Miami, 4-7. Tim Lincecum, 4-7 for the Giants. Two balls, two strikes. Rush is now over 60 pitches already. We're into the fourth. 2-2. Just missed outside. Three balls and two strikes. And as I mentioned, everything underway tonight, either at 7:05 or later in the American Association. The payoff pitch. Swing and a miss, and that changeup, and Espinoso waves right through it. Strikeout number three for Rush, and that's the first time in four innings that the Goldeyes have got the leadoff man for Lincoln. Amarillo at Grand Prairie tonight, Laredo at Kansas City, Wichita at Sioux City, and Fargo and New Jersey are in New Jersey at Yogi Berra Stadium. First pitch is right down the middle to Forgats for a strike. St. Paul at Gary, and at 8:05 tonight, Sioux Falls out in West Texas to take on El Paso. 0-1 is outside. One ball, one strike. And the MJBL tonight, a couple of 7 o'clock starts. Altona at St. B. Altona's 9-6. The Legionnaires are 4-11. 1-1 is low. Two balls and one strike. And Winnipeg South versus Carillon in Steinbach tonight. The Chiefs are 1-9. The Sultans are 8-5. 2-1 is low. Three balls and one strike. Basketball is done. Hockey, well, it's really getting good. At least two more games to go in that best of seven Stanley Cup final between Boston and Chicago. 3-1. Swung on, fouled back, right into the screen. 3-2. Forgats tonight is 0-1. He struck out, hitting .249, a right-handed batter. Three balls and two strikes on him. We're in the top of the fourth, tied at 2. The payoff pitch. Swung on, and that is lined to center field for a base hit. And Forgats will have a one-out single. Hit number 4 for Lincoln off Matt Rush. The batter is Tyler Goodrow. Here this fourth inning, let's have a look at what the Goldeyes are doing this week. It's brought to you by Boston Pizza. Hoey, come and try Boston Pizza's new Meteor Fall Off the Bone Ribs. Boston Pizza, if you ain't ribbing, you ain't living. Here's Tyler Goodrow, a double and a run scored tonight. First pitch, breaking ball, swung on and missed. Good slider there from Matt Rush. While the Goldeyes play game 2 of this series tonight, back into the doubleheader. Game 3 goes tomorrow evening at 6:05. We'll be on the air at 4:30 with Around the Association. 5:30 pregame show for Winnipeg Insurance. 0-1. High, one ball, one strike. And then on Sunday, the series will conclude. We're on the air at noon, 55 with Borney, 1 o'clock pregame, 1:35. First pitch. And then the Goldeyes and Lincoln Saltdogs are done with each other for the regular season. 1-1. Breaking ball is low. Two balls and one strike. Goldeyes will have Monday as a travel day. And they open up in Sioux City on Tuesday night. Sioux City, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Gary, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. So into next weekend. Then an off day to come home on Canada Day. 2-1. Swung on, lifted down the right field line toward the corner. It's well struck but foul. And Josh Mazzola ran out of room. Two balls, two strikes. And then Winnipeg is back home. for a pretty good stretch. Four with St. Paul, four with Gary. 10 days, basically. 8 games. Two and two here to Goodrow. And a pickoff attempt over at first, and Forgats diving back in. Forgats is 11 of 12 of the base paths. Already tonight, Lincoln has swiped two bases. Second and third, both by Daniel Carroll. 2-2, swung on, fouled back over the screen and down into the main grandstand for a souvenir. 2-2. So that's what the Goldeyes are doing. Tomorrow night is party on the patio deck. And a pickoff attempt, and just back in time again is Forgats. He almost stumbled there on that first step back. Had he would have been DOA on that tag by Casey Harther. Tomorrow, the game sponsor is the ALS Society, and it's the pregame reenactment of Lou Gehrig's famous farewell speech. Another pickoff attempt, and again, diving back in is Forgats. And Bones Lemoyne does a real good job of that. He even looks like Lou Gehrig. Two balls, two strikes. The pitch, runner on the move, pitches outside, throw down to second is not in time. Stolen base for Forgats. And the count 3-2 to Tyler Goodrow. Sunday, there'll be fun and games on the promenade. And you can bring your buddy to McDonald's. All fans will receive a 2-for-1 iced frappe coupon as they exit the ballpark.
Oh, dear.
And after the game, kids run the bases for free, courtesy of Kid City. 3-2. Breaking ball, swung on, fouled back. Always a $5 ticket. And the price point starts at $5. 5, 7, 12, 14, and $18 available at the door. Any Ticketmaster location in the province, including the box office here at Shaw Park, Ticketmaster.ca or 855-GOLDEYE. 3-2 pitch, breaking ball swung on and missed, and that is a great at-bat for Tyler Goodrow. Even better pitching by Matt Rush as he wins that battle. So, four strikeouts for Rush, two away in the inning. Tyler Goodrow went waving at that breaking ball and obviously didn't expect it at that point of the count. And got a little bit fooled on it. And here's Brian Emberry. Also, you can go to the Goldeyes website to check out the schedule or information if you can't make it to one of the remaining couple of games. Goldeyes are home a lot in July and August. The pitch is outside, ball one. Like I said, when they get home after this next road trip, they'll have 8 games at home before they go to Quebec and Rockland. It's Quebec, Trois-Rivières, Rockland. Then they're home again for a 4-game series. Actually, 3 games with Sioux Falls, 4 with Trois-Rivières, and then 3 more with Lincoln. Pitches in there for a strike. Throw down to second is off the glove of Sampson. It goes into center field. And up and making his way to third base is going to be Matt Forgats, and that'll be on the air to the catcher. They're going to charge the air on Luis Alen. And I apologize. Lincoln is back here one more time. They come back up here at the end of July and very early August for 3. And Brian Emberry with a 1-1 count on him. Two away, runner at third base. Rush will come set. The pitch is outside, 2-1. Two balls and one strike to Emberry, who bounced out to second base his first trip. He's 0-1. The 2-1. Swing and a miss in the off-speed pitch. 2-2. Yeah, here's who's still to come to Winnipeg. St. Paul, Gary, Sioux Falls, Trois-Rivières, Lincoln again, Sioux City, Sioux Falls again, Kansas City, St. Paul, and Fargo. Pitch is swung on, bounce right side to his left. Lyles up with it. Second baseman on to first, and the inning comes to an end. No runs, a hit, a Goldeyes error, one left. We'll go to the bottom of four in a 2-2 tie on TSN 1290.
Do you know where all your food comes from? Eating local is easy. At the Carver's Knife, all of the meat they sell comes from local Manitoba meat producers. Tender, aged beef, quality pork, and chicken. The Carver's Knife offers the finest meat products Manitoba has to offer. Because quality matters. It has to be the Carver's Knife. Supporting local farmers. 1530 Regent Avenue West and 39 Marion Street in the Dominion Center Mall.
Cambrian Credit Union members will never say things like,
I just love paying service fees.
My high mortgage rate is amazing.
Of course I'll pay $1.50 to use this ATM.
With Cambrian Credit Union's great rates and hassle-free services, our members know we have their best interest at heart. Save more of your money with refunded service fees from the UNFI and Cambrian Credit Union. Cambrian Credit Union, building strong financial foundations to make your dreams come true.
Impaired driving kills 30 people each year in Manitoba. Every drink affects your ability to drive safely. You might miss a stop sign or not see another vehicle. Maybe you don't notice the pedestrian crosswalk and you can't see the person walking right in front of you. If you plan to drink, plan ahead to get home safely. Don't drink and drive. A message from Manitoba Public Insurance.
We go to the bottom of the fourth inning. Leonard Davis to lead it off. He is the designated hitter tonight, followed by Phelan Lantini and Luis Allen. Hitters 5, 6, and 7 in a 2-2 tie for Winnipeg. All four runs were scored in the first inning and a half. Jose Melendez works into his fourth. Davis is 0-for-1. He struck out. Lefty-lefty, first pitch. Breaking ball, swung on, bounced right side, foul. And the Salt Dogs will get a right-hander up in the bullpen. And it looks like number 16. The 0-1. Breaking ball, swung on, lifted out toward right center. Striding forward is Daniel Carroll, and the center fielder will get there and make the catch. Wind is picked up here, and it kind of, I don't know if Leonard didn't get all of that, obviously. Kind of hung up in the air a little bit. Staten Thomas is getting loose in the bullpen, or at least starting to throw. Here's Phelan Lantini, an RBI single tonight. And he is 6 for his last 15 at the plate. First pitch. Fastball outside, ball one. And the 1-0 outside, two balls and no strikes. Game two, it'll be Pete Gehle versus Matt Bywater. A couple lefties, the pitch in there for a strike, and it's 2-1. Two balls, one strike, the pitch. Swung on and fell back. And it'll be 2-2. Two balls, two strikes. Lantini batting 306, five homers, 16 driven in. 2-2 pitch. Breaking ball, swung on. That's hit out towards center field. Carroll will stride again to get there and make the catch, retiring the other center fielder in this game. But we've seen that Daniel Carroll can cover a little bit of ground out there in center field. Gap-to-gap coverage for sure. Two away for Luis Allen. And Allen will step in from the right side. plate umpire Joe Piscucci will dust off the plate. Two catchers have a little chat while he's doing that. And Alen 0 for 1 tonight. Just about time for Luis and his first home run. First pitch is on the outside edge for a strike. He's not going to hit many, but he's always good for, you know, that five a year. The 0-1. Breaking ball is outside. One ball, one strike. Louis had five last year. Five the year before that. He had 11 in 2010. 1-1. Swung on and sliced down the right field line. Fair ball. Going to bounce in toward the corner. After it goes Embury. Striding around first. Heading for second is Al Capong. And he'll be in there with a stand-up 2-0 double. And the batter is Nick Liles. In Louis' first year as a Goldeye, hit three. Does not have one this year, but there's a double for Luis Allen, and he's pretty good at producing those as well. He had 32 years ago, 21 last year. Here's Nick Liles. First pitch is outside, ball one. We are tied at two. We're in the bottom of four, scheduled for seven. For Winnipeg, that was their fifth hit on the Culligan in-game line score. The pitch is low, 2-0. Two runs, five hits, and an error for Winnipeg. Two runs, four hits, and an error for Lincoln. Nick Liles 0 for 1 tonight, riding a seven-game hitting streak into this one. The pitch is a breaking ball that's in there for a strike. Two balls, one strike. And the pitch. Breaking ball in the dirt, and it got away from the catcher O'Donnell. Now he'll pick it up, throw to third, and it won't be in time. Luis Allen just got that foot in before the tag of Preventure. The ball squirted away from the catcher O'Donnell, just enough for Luis Allen to get over and take third. Three balls, one strike. And the pitch is outside, ball four. Second walk issued by Melendez tonight. There's runners on the corners for Nate Sampson. And Nate is 1 for 1. Sampson will stand in from the right-hand side. First pitch is in there for a strike. Nothing in one to Sampson. And the pitch swung on. That's hit out to right field. Back goes Embury, and he will back up and make the catch. Well-struck ball the other way, but the ballpark will hold it. And a right fielder makes the catch, and the Goldeyes come away empty here in what was shaping up to be kind of an exciting inning. For Winnipeg, no runs, a hit, and two left. We'll go to the fifth, tied at two, TSN 1290.
Now, more than ever, Metro Center gets you where you need to go. Winnipeg store for all things trailer now offers air miles, reward miles, and truck accessories. So, whenever you come to Metro Center for trailers, parts, hitches, and more, you can also earn air miles, reward miles. Get where you need to go with over 4,000 square feet of trailer parts, truck accessories, online ordering, knowledgeable staff, and trailer service at your Winnipeg trailer store. Metro Center 620 Nairn. Visit metrotrailers.ca.
This summer, Boston Pizza has introduced new Meteor Fall Off the Bone Ribs, baked in one of six tasty rib sauces like Jack Daniel's Barbecue, Honey Garlic, and our new Pizza too. So come on down to your local Boston Pizza. Bring your family. Bring your friends. Bring every ribneck you know. Because these damn there ribs are good, goody. Boston Pizza, if you ain't ribbing, you ain't living. Woo-wee!
Excuse me, it's my first day. Where's the copier?
It's not a copier, it's a Ricoh!
Okay.
Since Milne Office Systems tailored a Ricoh document management solution to our office, we've all been a little sensitive about our Ricoh.
The print quality's amazing.
The training from Milne was first class.
It's totally reliable, and we're saving money every month. So don't call it a copier.
It's a Ricoh!
Ricoh, the leading edge of business technology. Made easy by Milne Office Systems. Online at milneoffice.com.
Home of the Winnipeg Goldeyes. This is TSN 1290, tsn1290.ca. Now back to Paul Edmonds.
Well, we go to the top of the fifth inning, and it's a 2-2 tie. Provencher, O'Donnell, and Gomez scheduled hitters here for Ken Obergfell and the Lincoln Saltdogs against Matt Rush. Game two to follow tonight when we're all done with this one. We'll rechalk the line, spruce up the field a little bit, and way go for game two. First pitch to Provencher is right down the chute for a strike. Provencher 0 for 1 tonight with an RBI. 0-1. Breaking ball down and away. Thought about it, didn't go. One ball, one strike. Goldeyes are 6-6 here at home. 1-1. Swing and a miss in that slider. And what was a sparkling road record is now two games above 500 at 11-9.
Hey, buddy, you got one more strike left.
And overall, they're 17-15.
Come on, Mike. You can't hit it.
The 1-2 pitch. Fastball just missed outside. A little bit low maybe as well. 2-2. Goldeyes, let's put it this way. We're 10-3 in May. 2-2 pitch. Swung on, popped up. Right field, Mazzola is there. To his left, our right, and he will make the catch. With two hands. One down. Would you like to venture a guess on what the record is in June?
Number 14, John O'Connell.
Five games under 500 at 7-12. Another problem spot in terms of the numbers are the Goldeyes 3-10 record in their own division. First pitch to O'Donnell. Swing and a miss, and it's strike one. Nothing and one to the catcher, Sean O'Donnell. And the pitch. Swung on and filleted down the left field line, fouling into the seats. Good crowd down there in sections A, B, and C. Like full. Oh, it's all the trivia winners. The 0-2 is a little bit low. One ball and two strikes. Well, we don't give out the expensive tickets.
Come on, John. Swing.
The 1-2. Swung on and a comebacker. One hop fielded by Rush. All sorts of time to throw overhand to first, which he does, and there's two away. And it's Yasiel Gomez, the batter. He's 1-for-1. We're in the fifth inning, tied at 2. Gomez was caught stealing for the second out of the third inning after getting aboard with an infield single. First pitch is a slider that's low, ball one. One ball, no strikes. And the 1-0. In there for a strike, and it's 1-1. Talking about the Goldeyes with St. Paul when we were down there 1-1. Breaking ball is outside 2-1. And how the Goldeyes over the years, like, well, it would be from 94 through 2005, the 2-1 is outside 3-1. And then again from 2011 on, have really owned the St. Paul Saints in the head-to-head record. And Winnipeg doing the same with Lincoln. 39-28 is their record overall. The 3-1 swung on and fell back to the screen, 3-2. So 11 games above 500 overall are the Goldeyes against the Salt Dogs. And that would be from 2001 through 2005 as well. And then from 2011 on again, 3-2. Breaking ball swung on and pounded out toward left field. That's going to get down. It's going to get by Coles and go to the wall. And striding for second is Gomez, and he'll be in standing with a two-out double. And a hanging breaking ball there, and he pounded it. And here's Daniel Carroll, who's 1-for-2. So Lincoln has the potential go-ahead run here into scoring position with two down. Here's the most impressive part of the Goldeyes' overall record against Lincoln. Here at home, and remember, Lincoln has never, as a team based in Nebraska, never played anywhere else against Winnipeg but here at Shaw Park. The Goldeyes have lost in 30 starts. This is the 31st game between these two here in Winnipeg. First pitch, swing and a miss for strike one. In 30 starts, Winnipeg has only lost 8 times here at home to the Salt Dogs. They are 22-8. And in Lincoln, Lincoln owns that portion of the head-to-head. 0-1. Breaking ball swung on and missed. Nothing in two. The Goldeyes are 17-20 in Lincoln. That's not bad. Three games under 500 in a road ballpark. I mean, you want to play 500, but when you're 11 games above overall in the overall head-to-head, three games under is not bad. But the most impressive part, 22-8 here at home against the Salt Dogs. 0-2 to Carroll. Breaking ball swung on, popped up. Foul territory, first base side. Harther is there, and he'll make the catch. And the inning is over. No runs, a hit, one left. We'll go to the bottom of 5, tied at 2. You're listening to Goldeyes Baseball on the home of the Goldeyes, TSN 1290.
If I said to you, you had a beautiful body, would you hold it against me? Well, not if you got the body work done at Morey Auto Body, because beautiful body work is what they do best. They're not part of some giant chain, so they treat every customer like their only customer, and that means attention to detail like you wouldn't believe. Frame straightening, expert refinishing, even boat repairs, painting, and deckling. Morey Auto Body does it all and does it right. Really right. Right where you'd expect them to be, at 700 Morey. These guys hit it right out of the park.
Hi, I'm Denny from Denny's Whole Hog Barbecue. There's nothing better than a fully catered barbecue.
And I'm quarterback Buck Pierce. And I want you to call Denny's Whole Hog Barbecue now to book your fully catered barbecue or try a do-it-yourself hog roast.
It's fun, delicious, will cost less than you think. Plus, you can keep the leftovers. We'll even pack it up for you. Dates are filling up, so act fast.
Visit Danny'sWholeHog.com or call 344-5675.
And we'll bring the flavor.
Selkirk Chrysler's massive factory-authorized truck sale is on now. Find a huge selection of 2013 Ram pickups, quad cab, crew cab, regular cab, gas, diesel. We have them, and they're on sale. Savings up to $17,000 with super low financing. Like the regular cab 4.7 liter with air conditioning, only $17,995 or just $109 bi-weekly. Only at Selkirk Chrysler's factory-authorized truck sale. Details at SelkirkChrysler.com.
Well, we go to the bottom of 5 in a 2-2 tie in what's been a real good game. And the line score for Culligan is the same for both teams. 2 runs, 5 hits, and 1 error. Top of the order for Winnipeg, Coles, Ramon, and Mazzola. First pitch from Melendez is a fastball that's outside. Ball one, the bottom of five is underway. Thanks for joining us tonight. Wherever you're hanging your hat, 1-0 is in there for a strike. Here at the ballpark, Winnipeg, Capital Region, rural Manitoba, into the United States. And how do you folks on the World Wide Web? The 1-1 inside, two balls and one strike. Chicago Cubs have hung on and beat the Houston Astros 3-1 today. Matt Garza the win. He goes to 2-1. 2-1 pitch. Swung on, fouled away. Mike Coles has a double and a run scored and a strikeout tonight. He was part of that strike him out, throw him out double play. Where Sampson, after Coles had struck out, tried to get to second base and was thrown out on the caught stealing 2-6. 2-2. Breaking ball is high, 3-2. No activity in either bullpen now. Three balls, two strikes to Mike Coles. By the way, folks, Sal's win a winnie dog when the Goldeyes win following any home game this season. The payoff pitch is inside, ball four. So Coles draws a walk to lead off. Fans, you can take your game ticket to any of the Sal's Express locations to receive a free winnie with the purchase of fries to be redeemed within 7 days of the game. Courtesy of Salisbury House. Now, the offer is not valid here at Shaw Park. And it's one offer per ticket, per person, per visit. So a leadoff walk here to start the bottom of five. Third walk issued by Melendez. And here's Ramon, who's 0 for 2. And he's going to show bunt and lay one down up that first base line. It's picked up by Goodrow. And he applies a tag. And that was a bit of a shot. I think Amos thought, I don't know if he was a little rough there in applying the tag. He almost pushed him out of the baseline. Now, Amos tried to get wide on him, but sacrifice goes three unassisted, and then Amos gave Tyler Goodrow just a little tap on the back there just to say, okay, good job, no harm, no foul. Here's Josh Mazzola with a runner into scoring position as Mike Coles advances to second easily. And Mazzola, 0 for 1 with a walk and a run scored. First pitch, breaking ball is in there for a strike. And now the Goldeyes will get some people up in the bullpen. 0-1, breaking ball, bounced out toward third. Fielding that is Preventer. He's going to throw across, holding the runner at second. And he gets Mazzola at first for the second out. And the batter is Casey Harther. And Arthur, 1 for 2 tonight. Lefty should be Lafferty, and it is. And the right-hander is Kissick. Double-barrel action of the Goldeyes bullpen. And now the battery here for Lincoln. Want to talk about this. Casey Arthur tonight, an RBI single. And then he bounced out to second base. And Arthur stands in after that little meeting between the battery. Melendez comes set, first pitch is in there for a strike. Coles at second base. With two away in the bottom of this fifth, and we are tied at two. Arthur leads the team with 21 RBI. The pitch swung on, ground ball down the first baseline, but foul and a bit of a late swing by Casey. And it's nothing to two. Arthur hitting 311. Six homers, 21 driven in, as I mentioned. The 0-2 is high, one ball and two strikes. Yeah. Game one tonight is not only important for the team that wins it because they have a chance to sweep in game two, but it's a tone setter for the whole series. 1-2 is high, 2-2. Casey Arthur, another of the many Californians on this Goldeyes team. Two balls, two strikes. The pitch. Breaking ball, nubbed off the end of the bat, rolled out toward first, fielded by Goodrow. He'll make the unassisted play, and the Goldeyes are done in the bottom of five. So the leadoff walk gets stranded at second. No runs, no hits, and one left. We'll go to the sixth in a 2-2 tie on TSN 1290.
Nice day. Want a drink?
Yeah. Pass me a Pepsi.
How you doing?
Whoa. Do you hear that? Open your Pepsi.
How you doing?
That was awesome.
Hit it out of the park this summer.
How you doing?
With the cool, refreshing taste of Pepsi. Pepsi, live for now.
Impaired driving kills 30 people each year in Manitoba. Every drink affects your ability to drive safely. You might miss a stop sign or not see another vehicle. Maybe you don't notice the pedestrian crosswalk and you can't see the person walking right in front of you. If you plan to drink, plan ahead to get home safely. Don't drink and drive. A message from Manitoba Public Insurance.
Knowledge is power.
Get the power you need to succeed at CDI College.
With relevant, focused career training for business, healthcare,
art and design, legal, technology, and more.
Learn more.
Earn more.
Get more out of life with a career you love, not just a job.
Find your passion at cdicollege.ca.
CDI College. We change lives through education. CDI.
I love it, and we will succeed.
You're listening to Goldeyes Baseball on TSN 1290, tsn1290.ca. Brought to you in part by South Beach Casino. Like it, love it.
To the sixth we go. Stephen Douglas to lead it off for Lincoln. Douglas Espinosa, Forgats, 2-3-4 in the order in a 2-2 tie. Matt Rush works into his sixth. And there's some just-in-case down in that bullpen happening for Winnipeg. First pitch is swung on and missed for strike one. And now Lincoln has some people back up throwing. A right-hander. Nothing and one to Stephen Douglas. The pitch is on the inside edge for a strike. Nothing and two. It's Staten Thomas back up again throwing to the bullpen. Stephen Douglas here tonight has popped out and flown out. And the 0-2 pitch is inside with that fastball. One ball and two strikes. Just a reminder, folks, once again, Wendy's Restaurants and Baseball Manitoba have teamed up to form a great partnership this spring. 1-2. Swung on, looped over first, dumped into right field for a base hit. Leadoff single for Stephen Douglas. Sixth hit for Lincoln. And David Espinosa, the batter. I guess it's not really spring anymore. We're first day of summer today. The Joint Initiative provides an opportunity for all minor baseball players in the province to learn more about the game and the Goldeyes through a full-color baseball booklet that was distributed to all players following registration for minor baseball in the province. Now they're going to have a pinch runner here for Stephen Douglas, the DH in number four. Brad Payne is going to come out to pinch run. So look maybe for David Espinosa, even though he's hitting in the three hole, to play small ball here. So pinch running in this sixth inning is Brad Payne for Stephen Douglas.
Number four, Payne, Payne,
So let's see if David Espinosa, who's 0 for 2, tries to lay down a bunt. Rush comes set. First pitch is right down the middle for a strike. He does not. Espinosa tonight has bounced out in the first but drove in a run and then struck out in the fourth. Nobody out, one on. 0-1. It's outside. One ball and one strike. Wendy's also, by the way, provided each player with a free Frosty, redeemable at any Wendy's location in Manitoba. The Goldeyes, Wendy's, and Baseball Manitoba, a guaranteed triple play. Throw over to first and Payne back in time. Espinosa batting 266, four homers and 12 driven in. Matt Rush leaning over to get the sign. Comes set, the 1-1. Now a bunt is attempted by Espinosa, and he missed it. Broke the plane of the plate, or did they say he got a piece of it anyway? Goes back into the glove of Allen. It's a strike, and it's 1-2. One ball, two strikes. Brad Payne over at first base. Rush comes set. The throw goes over to first. And Payne back in time. One ball, two strikes. And time called by the catcher, Luis Allen. One ball, two strikes. And the pitch swung on and flared down the left field line. Long run for Coles. Here he comes and couldn't get to it in the bullpen. One ball, two strikes to David Espinosa. One ball, two strikes. Chris Kissick is now the only one throwing in the bullpen. Runner at first base. We're in the sixth, tied at 2. Scheduled for 7. Matt Rush will come set again. And the pitch swung on, line to right field for a base hit. And they're going to wave Payne up with the ball as Mazzola. His throw will be on one hop to third, not in time. And there's runners on the corners and nobody out for the Salt Dogs. And here comes Rick Forney, and he is going to likely make a pitching change. And Matt Forgach will be the batter. In Forney before he gets out to the mound, points down to the bullpen. That will be it for Matt Rush. He'll hand the ball off. And the day will start for Chris Kissick when we come back in 60 seconds. Sixth inning. And it's tied at 2. And runners on the corners for Lincoln. Call the bullpen being made back after these on TSN 1290.
What should we bring to the lake for dinner tonight?
Something easy that we can throw in the cooler.
Turkey?
Granny's Poultry introduces their seasoned turkey breast roast.
Sounds good.
Really good.
Pick up a frozen Granny's seasoned turkey breast roast from your neighborhood Safeway store. Throw it in the cooler, and by the time you get to the lake, it's barbecue ready. Granny's Poultry, your local poultry farmers cooperative. For simple and simply delicious recipes, visit grannys.ca. Granny's, good natured.
Greenwood Inn and Suites. They come by their name honestly. Greenwood is one of the few Winnipeg Airport hotels awarded a 4-key eco rating. Their strong commitment to our environment extends to creating the most comfortable home away from home for their guests. Special group room rates, 8,000 square feet of meeting space, on-site pool, hot tub, steam room, restaurant, and lounge, plus complimentary airport shuttle service, parking, and more. Bring your special events home to the Greenwood Inn and Suites. Greenwood, Winnipeg.
Your
your home of the Winnipeg Goldeyes. This is TSN 1290, tsn1290.ca. Now back to Paul Edmonds.
Well, we're in the sixth inning, and the Goldeyes and Saltdogs are tied at two, but the Saltdogs are threatening. Runners on the corners and nobody out. And the Goldeyes bring in Chris Kisick out of the bullpen here to face Matt Forgatch. That's it for Matt Rush, pitcher of record. If one or both of those runs come in that Chris Kisick inherits, so far a no decision right now for Rush. Five plus innings, seven hits, two runs. Both are earned, responsible for two. No walks and four strikeouts. Pitching change brought to you by Johnson Waste Management, 452-0909. So here's Matt Forgatch, one for two tonight. Infield back, the Goldeyes will play for two. First throw goes over to first base, and back in time is Espinosa. Forgatch batting .279. Two homers and 19 driven in. First pitch, breaking balls in there for a strike. For Chris Kisick, a right-hander out of British Columbia, 28 years old, 6'4", 185, from Fruitvale or Trail. Good numbers for Winnipeg so far out of that pen. The 0-1. Fastball swung on, lifted out toward left. Coles is there, should be a tag, and Coles will not even attempt a throw toward home. It will go toward second base. Tagging and scoring is Brad Payne on the sack fly, and Lincoln leads it 3-2. So they get the first out, and now Matt Rush is the pitcher of record on the losing side. And they hold David Espinosa at first base. You know, for Mike Coles, that's a smart play. You realize you're not going to get the runner from left field on a throw home. So throw to the right base. Don't give up the extra base. First pitch is bounced left side foul by Tyler Goodrow, who's one for two tonight. A double, a run scored, and a strikeout. For Chris Kisick, his 17th appearance of the year. Second most on the team behind Brendan Lafferty. He's 0-1 with a 1.13 ERA. 16 innings, 11 hits, 2 earned runs, 3 walks, 20 strikeouts in 16 innings. Pitch is swung on and missed, nothing in two. Now the opposition batting .180 against him. We're in the top of the sixth inning, 3-2 Lincoln. One out, one on. 0-2 pitch. Breaking ball swung on, bounced out toward third. Waiting for it is Ramon. He'll field it and throw across. That's the only play he had. It was just hit too slow to him to even think about two. So they get Goodrow on a corner-to-corner put out. Espinosa advances to second. Here's Brian Emberry, who's 0-2 this evening. And a left-handed stick. Emberry has bounced out twice to second. Left-handed batter, and Kisick will come set. First pitch. Swung on, lifted down that left field line toward the corner. High, deep, here comes Coles on the run! And he dives and makes the catch. What a grab by Mike Coles into his bullpen area, or just back in behind it. On full flight, having to keep in mind that he was getting close to the seats. And he dove and made the catch for the final out here in the sixth. Well, Lincoln, though, gets the go-ahead run. A run on two hits, and they leave one. We'll go to the bottom of six. 3-2 for the Saltdogs on TSN 1290.
If I said to you, you had a beautiful body, would you hold it against me? Well, not if you got the body work done at Morey Auto Body, because beautiful body work is what they do best. They're not part of some giant chain, so they treat every customer like their only customer, and that means attention to detail like you wouldn't believe. Frame straightening, expert refinishing, even boat repairs, painting, and deckling. Morey Auto Body does it all and does it right. Really right. Right where you'd expect them to be, at 700 Morey. These guys hit it right out of the park.
Hi, I'm Denny from Denny's Whole Hog Barbecue. There's nothing better than a fully catered barbecue.
And I'm quarterback Buck Pierce. And I want you to call Denny's Whole Hog Barbecue now to book your fully catered barbecue or try a do-it-yourself hog roast.
It's fun, delicious, will cost less than you think. Plus, you can keep the leftovers. We'll even pack it up for you. Dates are filling up, so act fast.
Visit Danny'sWholeHog.com or call 344-5675.
And we'll bring the flavor.
Team's playing great.
Yeah, we're up by two.
Big deal. I've got a 7,000-point lead.
What?
You haven't heard? I've had a fantastic season at Husky Stations this year. It's free to join, and it's easy. All you have to do is swipe, earn, and redeem to get great My Husky rewards like free gas and car washes.
My Husky Rewards. Visit your local Husky to get a card and start earning today. For more information, visit myhuskyrewards.ca.
I've still got a 6,999-point lead on them.
Bottom of the sixth inning, and a new pitcher here for the Lincoln Saltdogs, and it's going to be number 27, PJ Zacchi, who will be one of our guests tomorrow on Around the Association. And Zacchi is now the setup guy for this Lincoln team after being the closer. And the closer, I mean, they've got a real good eighth and ninth inning combination here. Is R.J. Rodriguez, who you got to know is probably warming, or, well, he's not warming right now, but he's not far away from doing that should they hold this lead for another inning. P.J. Zacchi comes in for Moise Melendez, who goes five innings. And Leonard Davis is the batter, as Zacchi, a right-hander, will come set after getting the sign. First pitch is on the outside edge for a strike. Pitching change brought to you by Johnson Waste Management, 452-0909. Melendez, five innings. Five hits, two runs. They're both earned. Three walks, four strikeouts. Pitcher of record, winning side, the 0-1. Is a little bit high, one ball, one strike. It's Davis, Lentini, and Allen against this right-hander who's originally from the Bronx, New York, is P.J. Zacchi. 1-1. Is on the outside edge for a strike. 1-2. And for Zacchi, he makes his 13th appearance. How about these sparkling numbers? 3-0, a 0.75 earned run average. 12 innings, 6 hits, 1 earned run. 1-2 pitch. Swung on and fouled to the plate. And Davis will stay alive. Three walks, 10 strikeouts. He's given up one homer, and the opposition hitting a meager 143 against him. Leonard Davis is 0 for 2 tonight. One ball, two strikes. Zacchi comes set, and the pitch. Swung on, ground ball out towards short to his right. Gomez, backhanded pickup and a throw to first. And leaning back behind the bag was Goodrow with the stretch. He keeps his foot on the bag, and they get Davis for the first out. And the batter is Phelan Lantini, who is 1 for 2. 3-2 in favor of the Salt Dogs here. And Phelan Lantini, an RBI single in the first. He flew out to center field in the fourth. First pitch. Breaking ball is in there for a strike. Let's have a look at the answer and pass along the winner's name on trivia here. Everything gets kind of shortened down a little bit on a seven-inning game. And trivia, as always, for the Place Louis Riel Suite Hotel in downtown Winnipeg. The 0-1. Fastball swung on and missed, nothing in two. Class Louis Riel, specializing in spacious executive suites. We wanted to know that the Goldeyes have been involved in five walk-off wins this season. I wanted to know their record in those five games. Congratulations tonight to Steve Weeb of Altona. 0-2, half a swing, fouled back, into the seats it goes. And still nothing in two to Phelan Lantini. Not Altoona, the AA affiliate of Pittsburgh, but Altona. Nothing in two to Lantini. Sachi comes set. The pitch. Swung on, high chopper out toward third. Preventer waits for it, pulls it down, throws to first in time to get Lentini two away. And the batter is Luis Allen, who's one for two tonight. The answer, 3-2. Three wins, two losses in walk-offs this year. Of course, St. Paul walked off victorious on Wednesday night. That was the last walk-off win the Goldeyes had been involved with. Congratulations, Steve Weeb, tonight. You knew the answer. You pick up a pair of Goldeye tickets to a future home game, and you'll also be eligible to win the grand prize of a weekend stay at the Place Louis at the end of the season. First pitch to Luis Allen, half a swing. Did he go? The appeal, no, says Brock Ballou. Ball one on that breaking ball that was low. Three-two for Lincoln. The 1-0. Breaking ball bounced out towards short to his right, and Gomez had to go under his glove. And it spills into left field. And Luis Allen has his second hit of the night. And Nick Liles will be the batter. And Liles will step up and in from the right-hand side. Nick is 0-for-1 with a walk. I actually said that he was on a 7-game hitting streak. It is 10. Looking to make it 11 here. Righty-righty, Zachi to his chest. First pitch, fastball inside, ball one. 3-2, Lincoln in front. We're in the bottom of six, scheduled for seven tonight. Zachi comes set again. Okay, lead for Allen. The 1-0 is high, two balls and no strikes. Couple of fastballs there, that one 93 on the gun. Liles has popped out and walked tonight. He would certainly take another base on balls. Zachi comes set. And the pitch. In there for a strike, and it's 2-1. Nick Liles hitting 252, no homers and seven driven in. Two away in the inning, runner at first base. The 2-1, swung on and filleted down the right field line, but foul. And it's going to get into the dining terrace of the clay oven. Two balls and two strikes. Good crowd is assembled here tonight. Late arriving. 2-2 pitch. Swung on, ground ball right side. To his left, Espinosa up with it on to first as he was a step into the outfield grass. And the Goldeyes are done here in the bottom of the sixth. No runs, a hit, and one left. We will go to inning number seven. 3-2, Lincoln leads it, TSN 1290.
We keep old files because they're out of sight and out of mind, or because we think we have to. But someday, those old files could bite us if they get in the wrong hands. isn't it time you let bygones be bygones? Have Protect Document Destruction's mobile service professionally shred your files wherever they are to rid yourself of those ticking time bombs. Protect Document Destruction, 975-0505, a division of Johnson Waste Management.
If your business, big or small, has excess waste and recycling piling up, let BFI Canada make your trash our business. Our customized pickup schedules make it easy. With commercial and industrial collection services, BFI Canada can help any business get organized. Want to make your business feel like new? Then call up the blue. Visit BFICanada.com to schedule your pickup date today. BFI Canada, a cleaner community, a greener environment.
Block parties, weddings, whatever. Make your next party a backyard affair with Archangel Fireworks.
Hey, friendo.
Shh, I love this one.
Yeah, me too. So, I just want to say,
shh, watch this.
Buddy, you throw the best parties.
Birthdays, office functions, tea parties. With Archangel Fireworks, the sky is your canvas. See them at Confusion Corner and at archangelfireworks.com.
You're listening to Goldeyes Baseball on TSN 1290.
TSN1290.ca.
Brought to you in part by South Beach Casino. Like it, love it.
We go to inning number 7. And Chris Kissick will stay on the hill for Winnipeg, coming in and working the full inning of 3 outs in the 6th after Matt Rush faced the first 2 batters. Lincoln leads this one 3-2. We're scheduled for 7. Bottom 3 in the order for the Salt Dogs, Preventure, O'Donnell, and Gomez. First pitch. And a bunt is pushed up the third base line. Foul by Preventure. Strike 1. Venture is 0 for 2 tonight. He bounced out to short, which ended up scoring Tyler Goodrow in the second, and then he's flown out to right field. And has strike 1 on him. R.J. Rodriguez is warming up in that bullpen for the Lincoln Salt Dogs. The 0-1. Swing and a miss. Good breaking ball, and it's nothing and two. And Preventure looked fooled on that. Preventure batting 187 coming in. 0-2 is a breaking ball in the dirt. 1-2. One ball, two strikes. And the pitch, swing and a miss, and the ball was dropped by Alen. And he will pick it up, though, and step into a throwing lane and complete the putout with a throw down to first base. So a strikeout and a 2-3 putout on Proventure. Good block there by Alen. And Sean O'Donnell, the other catcher in the game, will step up. He's 0 for 2 here this evening. Donald was struck out and bounced out. And he also struck out to earn everybody pancakes back in the second, and they have acknowledged the fact with a thanks for the pancakes message on the video board here. First to him is a strike as he swung and missed. The 0-1 is outside, 1-1. One ball, one strike. The pitch from Kissick swung on and missed, and it's 1-2. 1-2 to Sean O'Donnell. Kissick from the stretch with 1 away here in the 7th. The pitch, swing and a miss, and O'Donnell down on strikes. Good breaking ball there again. Second strikeout tonight for Kissick. Second time that O'Donnell is fanned. Back-to-back strikeouts. And there's 2 away for Yacel Gomez. Number 9 batter. Speaking of number nine batters, Nate Sampson, the number nine batter in the Goldeyes order, will lead off the bottom of seven, followed by Coles and Ramon. First pitch, right down the chute for a strike. Nothing and one to Yacel Gomez. And the pitch is a little bit high. One ball, one strike. And those three, Sampson, Coles, and Ramon, are likely to see the closer for Lincoln, R.J. Rodriguez. 1-1. Breaking ball just outside, 2-1. Two balls, one strike. And the pitch is low, 3-1. Game two, Pete Gehle versus Matt Bywater, a couple of left-handers. And the pitch is outside, ball four. And Gomez will get aboard for the third time tonight as the Goldeyes walk their first batter of the evening here in the seventh inning. And Daniel Carroll, the batter, 1-for-2. Actually, 1-for-3. He's popped out twice and had a single, stolen two bases, and scored tonight. Yacel Gomez over at first base is 2-for-2 with that walk now as well. First pitch is in there for a strike. Daniel Carroll, 4 home runs, 14 driven in. We've seen his abilities in center field tonight. The 0-1, breaking ball, swung on and missed, and it's nothing and two. Nothing and two to Daniel Carroll. And Kissick will come set, and the pitch. Swing and a foul back, or did he not get a piece of it? It got by Luis Alen and down to first base, likely on the wild pitch after the strikeout is Carroll. And they're going to call it a passed ball. So record a strikeout for Kissick, but the ball got away from Luis Alen. And it's a passed ball. Puts runners at first and second. The ball went all the way back to the screen and stayed there. And Brad Payne, the batter now, he came in to pinch run for Stephen Douglas in the sixth and scored the go-ahead run in this 3-2 lead for Lincoln. First pitch, swung on, ground ball right side, rolled right up to Liles, up with it, he flips to second, and they force Daniel Carroll there. So no damage done after the passed ball. However, the Goldeyes have three outs to go. Last chance coming up for them. Again, Sampson, Coles, and Ramon. They need one to tie, two to win it. Maybe in another walk-off. We'll find out when we come back. Make sure you do on TSN 1290.
Now, I'm not afraid to take risks under the perfect ideal conditions, but when it comes to pizza, I'll stick with Santa Lucia Pizza. Why risk getting anything less than Santa Lucia, voted best pizza in Winnipeg by Uptown Magazine readers for 6 straight years and winner of the Consumer Choice Award for best pizza restaurant for 7 years? I mean, after all, this is pizza we're talking about.
Don't risk ordinary pizza. Get Winnipeg's best at Santa Lucia Pizza. Dine in, take out, or home delivery.
You see, the best ingredients make the best pizza.
Like it? Love it! South Beach Casino and Resort is taking surf and turf to a whole new level. Start with surf on Thursday nights. Get ready for a taste of the sea with Manitoba's finest seafood feast buffet. Just $19.95. Grab a seat at Mango's Restaurant and dig in. On to turf. Saturday night, it's all about the prime rib. Enjoy this mouth-watering buffet for just $19.95. Don't miss this surf and turf adventure at South Beach Casino and Resort. For details, visit southbeachcasino.ca.
Ken Plain for Avalon. Do you have cracked basement walls, seepage problems, uneven floors, or sticking doors? Avalon is Western Canada's oldest and largest foundation repair company. Because Avalon repairs more basements than any other company, you shouldn't even think about having your basement repaired without talking to Avalon first. people you can trust at 783-2500.
We go to the bottom of seven. Last chance for Winnipeg, trailing 3-2 here in game one of this doubleheader. For P.J. Zacchi, he goes one inning, gives up a hit, no runs, no walks, no strikeouts, and he'll give way to R.J. Rodriguez, the closer for the Salt Dogs. The pitching change is brought to you by Johnson Waste Management, 452-0909. For R.J. Rodriguez, he's from Miami, Florida. 6 feet, 175. Previously in York in the Atlantic League and Campeche in the Mexican League. He's an LS5. And a right-hander who throws hard. And a guy that has recorded 12 saves this year for the Lincoln Salt Dogs. And here's Nate Sampson, who's 1-for-2. The 12 saves far and away lead the league. Rodriguez with 12. The next closest guy is Chase Johnson from Fargo with 9. So here we go. Sampson, Coles, Ramon. And Rodriguez will come set. First pitch is right down the middle for a strike. For R.J. Rodriguez, his 15th appearance, no record, but a 4.73 ERA. The 0-1, breaking ball is inside, one ball, one strike. 13 and one-third innings, 13 hits, 7 earnies, 3 walks, 15 strikeouts. He has given up 3 homers, and the opposition batting .245 against him. 1-1. Swung on a fastball and fouled away. Right side, one ball and two strikes. Almost 6,000 here tonight. 5,984. 5,984. One and two to Nate Sampson, who's 1-for-2 tonight. And the pitch is outside, 2-2. Nate batting .205, a home run, 11 driven in. And Rodriguez will come set again. 2-2, swung on, bounced down that third baseline foul. Nice snag by Rick Forney over there at the third base coach's box. One-hander. Goldeyes have some activity in the bullpen. And Patrick Keating, in case they tie this thing, and it goes to an extra inning. Two balls, two strikes to Sampson. The pitch. Fastball on the outside edge for a called third strike. And Nate will go down looking. And Rodriguez paints the black on that. Fifth strikeout this evening for Lincoln pitching. And Mike Coles the batter. Coles 1-for-2 with a walk. And he'll stand in from the right side. So one away in the bottom of this seventh. And Rodriguez will come set. First pitch. On the inside edge for a strike. Mike didn't like the call. Nothing in one. Coles a double, a strikeout, and a walk tonight. And officially his first game back as a Goldeye. He was saying yesterday that he didn't have much sleep Wednesday night going into Thursday, and a pitch is outside, 1-1. Didn't sleep much on the plane, was on limited rest just to get here, and probably the rainout helped him in terms of him catching up a little bit. One ball, one strike. And Rodriguez will come set. The pitch is low, 2-1. Next game will follow the conclusion of this one by about 20 minutes. 2-1 to Mike Coles. The pitch swung on and sent out toward right field, toward the corner, Emberry, and he cannot get there. As it curled in toward the corner and then went into the grass berm area or at the end of it. And it's 2-2 to Coles. Coles last year hit 279. He had three homers and 50 driven in. He batted 221 as a Goldeye. He played 27 games plus the six in the playoffs for Winnipeg. A total of 104 at-bats. Two balls and two strikes. 3-2 Lincoln, bottom seven. One out. The pitch swung on and a comebacker right there to Rodriguez. He'll field that, run it halfway over to first, underhanded, and Coles is retired, and Amos Ramon is the last hope for Winnipeg in game one here tonight. And Ramon is 0-2 with a sacrifice. Coming up, we'll have a post-game show that will be brief, and then we'll get into the pregame for game number two, and part of that pregame will be an interview that I did earlier today with Ryan Skoma of the Winnipeg Goldeyes. Amos stands in from the right side. First pitch is in there for a strike. Looked a little high. A little bit of groaning going on. Nothing in one to Ramon. The pitch is outside, 1-1. One ball, one strike. Lincoln looking for their 20th win if they were to get it. 1-1. Swing and a miss on that fastball, and it's 1-2. And they're one strike away from picking up their 20th win. Goldeyes are one strike away from losing their third in a row. Goldeyes have swept a doubleheader and been swept this year. The 1-2 pitch. Called third strike on the outside corner with a fastball, and Lincoln wins game one, 3-2 here in Winnipeg. And R.J. Rodriguez picks up his second strikeout of the night. And that was pretty easy work as he sat Winnipeg down 1-2-3 here in the seventh. The final score, Lincoln 3, Winnipeg 2, totals in a brief postgame coming up next on TSN 1290.
Got all your bases covered? With Manitoba Blue Cross, you do. They provide peace of mind for you and your family, no matter what the situation. Planning on taking a little family trip? Make sure to get travel coverage from Blue Cross. Looking for more benefits for your employees? Look no further than Blue Cross. They also handle individual life insurance. It's a real triple play.
Contact your insurance broker or visit nb.bluecross.ca.
Manitoba Blue Cross, the color of caring.